having us here today. I especially appreciate everyone who made it out of the snow. It's actually an even bigger problem we were expecting, considering it's the first day of snow in D.C. for the year. My name is Deborah James, and I'm the International Program Director at the Center for Economic and Policy Research. Welcome to all of you. CEPR is an independent, nonpartisan think tank that was established in 1999 to promote democratic debate on the most important economic and social issues that affect people's lives, including issues like Social Security, gender and work, as well as the foreign and economic policies of the U.S. government, the World Trade Organization, and the International Monetary Fund. It's my pleasure today to introduce this event, an assessment of the first 2 years of the Morales administration in Bolivia. We are very honored today to have Jean-Paul Guevara Avila, the Director of Bilateral Relations of the Ministry of Foreign Affairs of Bolivia, and we'll also be hearing from Mark Weisbach, who is co-director of the Center for Economic Policy Research. First, we're going to hear from Jean-Paul Guevara. He was born in Bolivia and studied political science, international relations, and has lived in South Africa, Mexico, Argentina, Belgium, and the United States, in addition to Bolivia. Very well-rounded curriculum. He's published widely on themes of sustainable development, gender and development, migration and globalization, not just in Bolivia, but also in Argentina, Mexico, and other countries. He's a member of the International Society for Ecological Economics and other international and political economic investigation societies. And of course now, he is the Director General of Bilateral Relations of the Ministry of Foreign Relations of Bolivia. And we're very pleased to be hosting him today in snowy Washington. So without further ado, I present to you Mr. Guevara. Thank you.
Pleased to be here with you this morning, and I'm going to speak in Spanish. I feel more comfortable with my mother language, so we have a translator. She will help us this morning. Primero quería decir muchas gracias por la posibilidad de estar con ustedes. Agradezco mucho al CPL.
First of all, I wanted to thank you for the opportunity to be here with you today. I am very grateful to CPR.
También quiero dejarles a ustedes el mensaje de mi presidente Evo Morales y del canciller de Bolivia, David Choquehuanca. Un saludo muy cordial, muy amistoso, muy fraterno para todos ustedes.
I also wanted to give you greetings from our president Evo Morales and also of our canciller
David Choquehuanca.
David Choquehuanca, just a very, very cordial greeting from them to all of you.
Mi presencia aquí ahora tiene que ver con los dos años de gobierno que van a cumplirse en pocos días.
My presence here today has to do with the 2 years of government that in a few days are going to be accomplished.
Y por el fin del trabajo de la Asamblea Constituyente hace pocas semanas, que ha dado resultado un nuevo texto constitucional para Bolivia.
And also of the purpose of the Constituent Assembly, just a few weeks ago, it has produced new results of a new constitution and laws for Bolivia.
Como ustedes saben, Bolivia vive un momento muy importante de cambios, muy profundos y estructurales de nuestro país.
As you know, Bolivia is living right now very deep changes, very structural as well as governmental changes that our country is living right now.
Me parece importante primero señalar que son cambios que tenían un carácter de imperativo histórico para que ocurra.
I think it's important for me to point out that these are the types of changes that have a very important and significant historical context.
La situación como se vivía en Bolivia, con la exclusión, un apartheid no escrito, donde la mayoría de la población indígena estaba invisible para el Estado, no podía seguir igual.
The situation that Bolivia was living with the complete exclusion, a sort of a non-written apartheid with the indigenous people could just not continue in our country. Complete exclusion of the indigenous.
Sí. Además, ustedes saben que en Bolivia la mayoría de la población es población indígena.
And as you all know, you know that the majority of Bolivia's population is indigenous.
Esta voluntad de cambio de toda la sociedad se expresó en la votación de diciembre de 2005 para el presidente Evo Morales.
This will for change of the population of Bolivia was expressed in the election of December 2005 for President Evo Morales.
Como nunca sin antecedentes antes, él logró 54% de la votación de la población.
As had never been, had never occurred before, without president, he was able to achieve 54% of the population's votes.
Antes en la historia democrática, lo más alto de votación era 36%.
Before, previous to that, in the history of democracy, the highest that voting that took place was 36%.
Esa votación es la voluntad de cambio que había en Bolivia.
And this election and votes expressed the very strong will for change that was present in Bolivia.
Pero también esa voluntad de cambio tenía un sentido del cambio.
But that will for change also had a sense of what the change was.
Porque se eligió al primer presidente indígena de Bolivia.
Because the first indigenous president of Bolivia was elected.
Había la votación y había un sentido, o había la voluntad de cambio y había un sentido del cambio.
We had, there was the will for change, and there was also a sense, a purpose for the change.
Ese sentido era lo indígena en Bolivia.
And that sense and that purpose was what was indigenous in Bolivia.
Sí. Entonces, esta voluntad de cambio, este sentido del cambio también tenía un instrumento de cambio muy importante.
So this will for change and this sense for change also had a very important and significant instrument of change.
Y ese instrumento era la Asamblea Constituyente.
And that instrument was the Constituent Assembly.
Los dos elementos más importantes para el gobierno de Evo Morales, el mandato que tenía Evo Morales, era el tema de la Asamblea Constituyente y el tema de nacionalización de los recursos naturales.
The two most important things that were in Evo Morales' agenda in his leadership was the constitution, the development of the Constituent Assembly, and also the nationalization of Bolivian's natural resources.
En el plazo inmediato, el cambio pasaba por la nacionalización de los recursos naturales.
The first short-term and immediate change was the nationalization of the natural resources.
Y el cambio estratégico pasaba por la Asamblea Constituyente.
And the strategic change went through the Constituent Assembly.
Solo porque es importante recalcar, subrayar que la nacionalización de recursos naturales fue la nacionalización sobre los recursos, no sobre la propiedad de las empresas internacionales.
And it's very important to underline that that nationalization of the natural resources was not a nationalization over the resources themselves, but over, was a nationalization of the resources, but not of the propriety or ownership of those resources.
De la infraestructura.
Of the infrastructure.
No fue, por lo tanto, una nacionalización expropiatoria.
Therefore, it was not an expropriatory nationalization. It did not take property away.
Claro. No fue confiscatoria.
It did not confiscate,
sí,
property.
Las empresas que estaban antes en Bolivia continúan en Bolivia, pero con nuevos contratos.
The companies and the organizations that were previously in Bolivia continue being in Bolivia, only with new contracts, new leases.
Esto es muy importante porque es una característica de este nuevo gobierno, los consensos que se van logrando en el proceso.
And that is very important because it is one characteristic of this new government, the consensus that are being achieved constantly in the process.
Y esto me remite al otro instrumento de cambio estratégico que era la Asamblea Constituyente.
And this brings me to the other important change, which is the Constituent Assembly.
Porque el buscar el cambio por medio de una asamblea constituyente fue una decisión política de buscar el cambio democráticamente.
Because while looking for change by a constituent assembly was also looking for change in a way that was democratic.
Y esta definición no es de ahora, sino viene desde muchos años antes.
And this definition is not new, but it has been coming from many years past.
En 1990 comienza la demanda por una asamblea constituyente de parte de los movimientos indígenas en Bolivia.
Ever since 1990 was when a movement wanting, demanding a new constituent assembly began with the indigenous people of Bolivia.
Es desde ese año que el movimiento indígena define una vía no violenta para el cambio, cuando en Bolivia y en la región había movimientos violentos, guerrillas, para lograr el cambio social.
And it is ever since that year that the indigenous population, the indigenous movement in Bolivia went through a non-violent way to achieve change. When there were many movements previously that did have violence, like guerrillas and small wars.
Not only previous, but pero también el ese mismo tiempo not había otras opciones violentas.
Not only previously, but also during that same time, there were also other options that were violent.
Entonces eso da una característica permanente, estratégica al cambio por una vía democrática.
So this brings a permanent and strategic characteristic to the change, which is through a democratic means.
Y eso tiene mucho que ver con el carácter indígena y el carácter de diálogo que tiene la cultura indígena.
And this has very much to do with the character of the indigenous people and the characteristic of the will and the capacity for dialogue that the indigenous people have.
Por eso no se trata de un movimiento de izquierdas.
That is why this has nothing to do with the leftist movement.
No se trata de un movimiento clásico de una revolución socialista o algo así.
It has nothing to do, it is not at all the classical movement of a socialist revolution.
Sino también es una propuesta societal, cultural. Es un cambio democrático y cultural.
But it is a proposal that is for change that is cultural, the society. It is a change that is democratic and cultural.
Y entonces, desde entonces, se ha respetado escrupulosamente la institucionalidad democrática para lograr los cambios que se están buscando.
And ever since then, this characteristic has been followed scrupulously to achieve the democratic change that the people are yearning for, the social change.
Es por eso que el presidente Morales tenía que cumplir este mandato de lo que una asamblea constituyente que tenga un producto.
That is why President Morales had to achieve this mandate for a constituent assembly that could achieve a product.
Pero, como ustedes saben, un proceso de cambio afecta intereses particulares que son los que se oponían a que este cambio ocurra.
But as you well know, anything for a change affects some private interests that were the ones that were opposed to this change occurring.
Sí. Por lo tanto, permanentemente, desde 1990, había la oposición a que se concretice una asamblea constituyente.
Therefore, ever since 1990, there was a permanent opposition that was opposed to the visualization or to the achievement of a constituent.
Al principio, los partidos tradicionales se opusieron a dar una personería legal a los movimientos indígenas para que participen en el campo de los partidos democráticos.
At first, some of these parties that were opposed were very opposed to giving the indigenous people a legal voice to achieve a change in the country.
Y posteriormente, cuando se ve esa necesidad de cambio, esa voluntad de cambio, hacen pequeñas reformas a la Constitución.
And then afterwards, as they were seeing and noticing that will for change, they did some small changes to the Constitution.
Pero que no reconocía la institucionalidad, la identidad diferente de los pueblos indígenas.
But these changes did not recognize the individuality and the identity of the indigenous people.
Y la institucionalidad.
And the institutionality.
Porque existe, toda cultura tiene su institucionalidad, que es la que le permitió sobrevivir sin apoyo del Estado durante todos los años de la vida republicana. Toda cultura tiene su institucionalidad.
Because every culture has its own institutionality, which makes it able to
survive and reproduce.
Survive and reproduce.
¿Sí? Es así como en esta pugna llegamos a la Asamblea Constituyente.
That is how, with these challenges, we get to the Constituent Assembly.
Y como un instrumento democrático, también quienes se oponían a una asamblea constituyente pudieron ser electos en la asamblea constituyente.
And as in a democratic process, those who were opposed to the constituent assembly were able to get elected to the assembly itself.
Pero buscando siempre impedir el trabajo de la asamblea constituyente.
But always looking towards stopping or putting blocks, sabotage the changes that the Constituent Assembly was bringing up.
Fueron distintos argumentos que se fueron presentando para sabotear esta asamblea.
There were different arguments that were being put together in order to boycott this Constituent Assembly.
Había el tema de dos tercios de votación para aprobar los temas, los artículos de la Constitución.
There was the subject of the two-thirds that were necessary in order to approve the articles of the Constitution.
Que se incorporó en las normas de la Asamblea Constituyente.
And that was incorporated into the terms and regulations of the Constituent Assembly.
Se planteó el tema de las autonomías departamentales como un conflicto para que haya asamblea constituyente.
Also, the subject was brought about of the governmental autonomies or self-governing as a conflict to the constituent assembly.
The autonomy of the department, the province.
Autonomy of the departments or ministries.
Sí, y no ministros, sino regiones, departamentos.
States.
En el caso, states. Pero no es federal, no es estado.
But it's not a federal state. It's not a state because it's not federal.
Entonces, y eso también fue incorporado en la nueva constitución.
And that was also incorporated in the new constitution.
Pero también se presentó un tema sobre la localización de la sede de gobierno en las ciudades de Bolivia.
But also the subject was brought up of the localization of the place of the government, of the site of the government in Bolivia.
Y ahí era un problema muy difícil de resolver porque es un problema de infraestructura física.
And that was a problem that was very difficult to solve because it's a problem that is in physical infrastructure.
No se puede cambiar una ciudad de 2 millones de habitantes a cualquier lugar.
You cannot change a city of 2 billion population in to another place.
Pero eso fue un instrumento para impedir el trabajo de la Asamblea Constituyente por 6 meses.
but that was an instrument that was used in order to impede or to boycott the work of the Constituent Assembly for 6 months.
Y también fue un argumento para que la oposición no democrática ejercite la violencia para impedir la Asamblea Constituyente.
And it was also an instrument that was used so that the opposition, which was not democratic, could utilize violence in order to impede or to stop the Constituent Assembly.
Porque en un proceso democrático es normal que exista una oposición.
Because in any democratic process, it is natural that opposition is going to exist.
Pero tiene que respetar las reglas democráticas.
But it must respect the democratic rules.
Que son las reglas del juego para todos.
Which are the rules of the game for everyone involved.
Es por eso mismo que la Asamblea Constituyente no es solo un espacio de disputa de poder.
That is precisely why the Constituent Assembly is not merely a space of dispute for power,
sino también un proceso pedagógico de autorreconocimiento de la sociedad boliviana.
But also a scholarly process of the acknowledgement of the Bolivian population and the Bolivian peoples.
Porque las gentes que se decían democráticas,
because the people that were calling themselves democratic,
no respetaban las reglas democráticas.
Were not respecting the rules of democracy.
Las gentes que pensaban, que creían en los derechos y las libertades o la institucionalidad liberal,
the people that thought that they believed in the rights and the institutionality of a liberal state,
mostraban su racismo y su intolerancia.
Were showing their intolerance and their racism.
Entonces también es un proceso de reaprendizaje de la sociedad boliviana.
And so it is also a relearning process of the Bolivian society.
Sin dejar de lado una disputa real del poder entre las clases que se beneficiaban y se enriquecieron con el Estado y los movimientos sociales e indígenas presentes ahora.
And it is also a stage, a way to show a scenario of the dispute that was going on between the social and powerful classes of the rich and the indigenous people of Bolivia. Mm-hmm.
Ese proceso que tiene muchos muchos detalles de oposición, de confrontación.
That process which has many details of confrontation and exploitation.
Ha terminado ahora.
Confrontation has ended now.
Ha terminado respetando escrupulosamente, respetando al detalle las reglas de la institucionalidad democrática.
It has stopped while scrupulously respecting the rules of an institutionality of a democratic society.
Mm-hmm. Y ahora ya tenemos un nuevo escenario en Bolivia.
And now we have a new scenario in Bolivia.
Es esta nueva constitución producto de la Asamblea Constituyente.
This new constitution, which is a product of the Constituent Assembly,
da un nuevo escenario para el futuro de Bolivia.
Brings about a new scenario for the future of Bolivia.
Voy a dar algunos detalles de la nueva constitución que caracteriza la nueva constitución.
I'm going to give you a few details of what characteristics that are typical in the new constitution.
Hay una profundización de la cultura de derechos.
There is a deepening of the culture of rights,
derechos individuales,
individual rights,
colectivos,
collective rights,
de las mujeres,
women's rights,
jóvenes,
the youth,
niños, niñas,
boys and girls,
tercera edad,
senior citizens,
y también los derechos de los consumidores,
and also the rights of the consumer.
Como un paréntesis, sabía o tengo conocimiento de que en su país, en Estados Unidos ahora, no va a ser obligatorio mostrar la procedencia de los productos o si son transgénicos o no son transgénicos.
I have heard and I have knowledge that now in your country, in the United States, it is not going to be an obligation to show where products come from or whether they're transgenic
or not.
En
la Constitución de Bolivia ahora es obligatorio que todos los productos, que el consumidor sepa muy bien qué compone lo que está consumiendo.
Now in Bolivia, it is mandatory that the consumer knows exactly where the product or what he's consuming has come from and what it is that he's consuming.
Cierro el paréntesis.
Close parenthesis.
En términos de económicos, la Constitución reconoce la economía plural de Bolivia.
The Constitution recognizes the pluralized economy of Bolivia.
Reconoce las formas de organización económica privada.
It acknowledges the forms of private economic resources.
La economía estatal.
It recognizes state economy.
La economía comunitaria.
Community economy.
La economía social cooperativa.
And cooperative social economy.
Respeta claramente la propiedad privada.
It clearly respects private property.
Propiedad privada individual y propiedad privada colectiva.
Individual private property as well as collective private property.
También se reconoce y se respeta la sucesión hereditaria de la propiedad.
It also recognizes and respects the hereditary succession of the properties.
Igualmente, la nueva Constitución reconoce y asume la resolución de la Asamblea General de Naciones Unidas sobre los derechos de los pueblos indígenas.
It also recognizes the resolution of the United Nations of the rights of indigenous populations.
Reconoce el derecho de autogobierno y autodeterminación de los pueblos indígenas.
It recognizes the rights of self-governing and self-authorization of the indigenous populations.
Incorpora la institucionalidad propia de los pueblos indígenas dentro del Estado boliviano.
It incorporates the institutionality, the very own institutionality of the indigenous population into the nation of Bolivia as a whole.
Igualmente, la nueva Constitución profundiza la democracia en Bolivia.
In the same manner, the new Constitution deepens and goes delves well into the Bolivia's democracy.
Porque se señala que el Estado boliviano adopta la forma de gobierno democrático.
Because it is pointed out that the Bolivian state adopts the form of a democratic nation.
Democracia participativa.
Democracy that is participatory.
Representativa.
Representative.
Comunitaria.
Community based.
Con equivalencia de condiciones entre hombres y mujeres.
With the equivalence of conditions for between men and women.
Lo que significa que será 50-50 los cargos electivos.
Which means that the electoral positions will be 50-50.
Between men and women. También reconoce la independencia y separación de los poderes.
It also recognizes the independence and the separation of powers.
Reconoce la independencia del poder legislativo, judicial, ejecutivo y electoral.
It recognizes the differences between the powers of the legislative, judicial,
executive,
ejecutivo, and executive.
Sí.
Powers, the difference between.
Señala que se debe elegir mediante sufragio electoral, voto.
It points out that through votes, through electoral process, you must elect
al Tribunal Supremo de Justicia,
the Supreme Court of Law,
el Tribunal Constitucional,
the Supreme Court, and the Constitutional Court.
Sí.
Court.
y muchos otros cargos que antes no eran electos democráticamente.
And many other positions that previously were not elected or voted on in a democratic way.
Pone más controles para el poder de la presidencia.
It places more controls over the position of on the powers of the president.
No permite la elección indefinida.
It does not allow indefinite elections.
Solo se puede una vez ser reelegido.
You can only be re-elected one time.
Un poco como en Estados Unidos.
Somewhat like the United States.
Solo una vez y no más.
Only once and no more.
Porque yo escuché versiones de que decían que el presidente Morales quería ser reelegido siempre.
Because I heard some versions and some comments that President Morales wanted to be re-elected indefinitely.
Es parte de la campaña que existe en contra de
that is part of the opposition campaign that exists.
También se autoriza, se reconoce el referéndum revocatorio para el presidente.
It is also recognized the revocatory referendum for the president.
Sí. Lo cual son varios instrumentos que limitan la concentración del poder.
And these are some instruments that put limitations on the concentration of power.
Un punto muy importante.
Very important point.
Es que la nueva constitución
reconoce
la autonomía departamental,
recognizes the departmental autonomy,
que era una demanda de las regiones,
which was something that the regions were demanding,
pero reconoce también
but it also recognizes
la autonomía municipal que ya existía antes,
the municipal autonomy that used to exist previously,
y la autonomía indígena.
And the indigenous autonomy.
Que es la forma de reconocer los derechos de autogobierno.
Which is the form, it is the way to recognize the rights of self-governing.
De los pueblos indígenas.
Of the indigenous population.
Es decir, que la nueva constitución va más allá de la demanda que tenían las regiones sobre autonomía.
This means that the new constitution goes even further than the demands that the regions had previously regarding autonomy.
Porque también da la capacidad legislativa a las autonomías departamentales.
Because it also gives the legislative capacity to the governmental autonomies.
Las autonomías departamentales pueden hacer sus leyes.
The state autonomies can devise their own laws.
En el marco de sus competencias y de la unidad del Estado Nacional.
Within the framework of what they're competent to do under the national state.
La unidad del Estado.
The unity of the state.
Todos estos elementos muestran el carácter democrático que ha tenido los cambios que se están viviendo en Bolivia.
All of these details show the democratic character that all of the changes in Bolivia have.
Sin embargo, la oposición no siempre ha reconocido esto.
However, the opposition has not always recognized this.
Y hay una oposición democrática y hay una oposición no democrática.
And there is a democratic opposition and also a non-democratic opposition.
Una oposición que ha sido elegida y participó en la Asamblea Constituyente.
An opposition that has been elected and that took part in the Constituent Assembly.
Pero una oposición que fue elegida para la Asamblea Constituyente, pero que no participó de la Asamblea Constituyente.
But it was an opposition that was elected to the Constituent Assembly, but did not participate in the Constituent Assembly.
Y utilizó mecanismos fuera de la Asamblea Constituyente para frenar el trabajo de la Asamblea Constituyente.
And it used mechanisms and methods that were outside of the Constituent Assembly in order to put a stop to the Constituent Assembly.
Parte de esta oposición.
Part of this opposition,
cuando se aprueba el nuevo texto de la Constitución boliviana,
when a new text of the Bolivian Constitution is approved,
aprueban lo que se llaman los estatutos autónomos de las regiones.
they approve what is called the self-governing statutes of the various regions.
Sin ningún mecanismo democrático.
Without any democratic mechanism at all.
Sin elección democrática de las personas que escribieron estos estatutos.
Without democratic election of the people who wrote these laws.
Sin la consulta para ver los contenidos de estos estatutos.
Without consulting to see what the content of these statutes were.
Pero además,
also,
buscando la división de estas regiones del país con estos estatutos.
Looking at what the divisions were between the regions in the country regarding these statutes.
Porque esos estatutos hablan de su propia ciudadanía.
Because these statutes speak about their own citizenship.
Su propia policía.
Their own police.
Su propio aduana customs.
Their own customs department.
Su propia justicia.
Their own justice.
No? Su propia ley de impuestos.
Their own tax laws.
Todo al margen del Estado boliviano.
Everything completely marginalized from the Bolivian state.
Pero a pesar de esta pugna importante de poder,
but in spite of this very important clash for power,
el presidente Morales, buscando salidas y escenarios democráticos a la confrontación,
President Morales, while looking for changes that were democratic and were good for everyone for the Constitution,
planteó un referéndum revocatorio de las autoridades electas.
Set forth for discussion
referéndum revocatorio.
Revocatory referendum.
Para las autoridades.
For the authorities.
Sí.
A way to impeach them.
Sí. A pesar que los estatutos autonómicos no tienen una base legal, sino es con la nueva constitución.
That is, even though the statutes, the economic statutes, do not have a legal basis outside, unless it is with a new constitution.
El presidente Morales llamó un diálogo con la oposición para revisar esos estatutos autonómicos.
President Morales called for a dialogue in order to go over those economic statutes.
No solo presentó al Congreso una ley de revocatoria de mandato.
He not only presented to the state a law for power that was reversible.
Referéndum revocatorio.
Revocatory referendum.
Recall referendum.
También llamó a un diálogo con los prefectos.
He also called for a dialogue with the prefects.
El lunes 7 de enero de este año,
on Monday, the 7th of January of this year,
el presidente tuvo un diálogo abierto con los medios y televisado y por broadcast con radio.
The president had an open dialogue with all the media, which was televised and also broadcast on radio.
Esos son antecedentes que no existían en Bolivia.
These are precedents that did not exist in Bolivia.
Un diálogo abierto, transparente, no había antes en la clase política.
An open and transparent dialogue that simply did not exist before in the political class.
Pero era importante que toda la población sepa ¿Qué es lo que pide la oposición?
But it was important for the entire population to know what the opposition is asking for.
Porque el mayor problema de la oposición es no tener propuestas para Bolivia ahora.
Because the greatest problem that the opposition has is not to have any proposals for Bolivia right now.
La oposición no tiene conocimiento de un país indígena.
The opposition has no knowledge of an indigenous country.
Nunca pensó en una Bolivia indígena.
It never thought of an indigenous Bolivia.
Pero entonces el diálogo planteado por el presidente Morales es para escuchar sus propuestas.
And so the dialogue that was set forth by President Morales is to be able to hear and to listen to those proposals.
A pesar de todo la violencia y actos de racismo y discriminación de la oposición,
in spite of all the acts of violence and of racism of the opposition,
se sentaron en una mesa para dialogar.
They sat down at a table to have a dialogue.
Entonces, el presidente propuso crear una comisión para compatibilizar estatutos autonómicos y nueva constitución política del Estado.
So then the president...
Una comisión para...
The president wanted to form a commission in order to...
Compatibilizar.
Make compatible...
Los estatutos autonómicos...
The autonomous statutes...
con la nueva constitución del Estado,
with the new political constitution of the state,
o para mejorar cualquier contradicción que tenga la nueva constitución del Estado,
or to improve any contradictions that the new constitutional politics of the state might have.
Nos encontramos en ese momento ahora.
And we find ourselves at that very moment right now.
Pero lo cierto es que el escenario sobre el que se habla ahora,
but what is true is that the scenario over which, and the state over which now the dialogues are being held,
es nueva constitución política,
is a new political constitution,
que significa un cambio,
which means a change,
en la situación de Bolivia,
in Bolivia's present situation.
Okay. Voy a terminar ahí porque me importa mucho el diálogo que podamos tener.
Okay, I will end right here because I am very, very interested in the dialogue that we can have.
Muchas gracias.
Thank you very much.
Thank you so much for that incredibly rich overview. I've been studying Bolivia for a long time, and I certainly learned a lot from that presentation. We are going to have time for question and answers afterwards, but I'm going to invite, now at this point, actually, first I wanted to take the opportunity to recognize the presence in our room today of His Excellency Ambassador Gustavo Guzman. Thank you so much for joining us. I know many people in the room may know you, but many have perhaps have not had the opportunity to meet the Ambassador from Bolivia to the United States here in Washington. So thank you so much for joining us today.